Hi, my name is Lucy Rose Ruccio, and I just recently graduated from the DNP program at the University of Maryland School of Nursing. In this quality improvement brief, we're going to go over some tricks and tips to writing a quality improvement manuscript and how that looks different than a research manuscript. The objectives for this QI brief are to explain the basic components of quality improvement manuscript writing, and to demonstrate how to construct the components of a quality improvement paper. So what is implementation science? Implementation science is the scientific study of methods and strategies that facilitate the uptake of evidence-based practice research into regular use by clinicians. The field of implementation science seeks to close the gap between what we know and what we do. The DNP projects at the University of Maryland are quality improvement projects that use implementation strategies and tactics to improve healthcare by strategically implementing evidence-based practices. There's a separate QI brief on the basics of quality improvement versus research. If you have not viewed it, I highly recommend you do prior to starting your DNP project. Here you can see the citations for two different quality improvement papers. These are excellent examples that I recommend you look to as you write your own manuscript. You'll see quotations from both throughout the presentation, and both can be accessed through the Health Sciences Library. So, the Squire guidelines are a helpful tool that lay out how you should write a QI manuscript. You can see the full Squire guidelines online, but you will see snippets of them here. For a QI manuscript background section, you're trying to answer the question, why did you start this project? What problems led you here? What's already known on this topic? And what's the rationale behind why you chose your specific evidence-based intervention or solution? When you describe your problem, you want to give some important attention-grabbing and broad data, followed then by some narrow data that's specific to your context. You can see examples of that on the next slide. In the background section of your manuscript, it's where you will also discuss your chosen theoretical framework. Theoretical frameworks are required for the DNP project at UMSON. Theoretical frameworks serve as an organizing scheme or a particular lens through which to view the problem. They can be used in writing the manuscript, as well as frameworks help to break out complex concepts and facilitate discussion of barriers and facilitators. They can also be a way to talk about why decisions were made the way they were. Why did you focus on this intervention or this particular population? The section of the manuscript should begin with a brief one-paragraph description of the framework that could be understood by anyone, even those who are completely unfamiliar with the framework. This description should be followed by a discussion of how the components of the framework were used in planning the strategies and the execution of the project. These examples were pulled from the Bell article. For your broad and attention-grabbing statistic, you could say something like, cesarean deliveries are currently the most commonly performed surgical procedure in the United States. And after that, you want to narrow your focus down to your specific context and give some data and background there. For example, these three hospitals have a cumulative cesarean birth rate of 27.73%. In the background, you will also provide a single sentence purpose statement. There's a lot of information on how to do this in your Blackboard modules, but here are a few additional tips. The purpose statement should set limits on the scope of the project. Unlike a research paper, you want to focus on what you plan to implement. You are not endeavoring to answer a completely new research question. The purpose of a quality improvement project would not be to research whether or not the flu vaccine is effective, or whether this medication cures ovarian cancer faster than that medication. That would be a research paper. The purpose of a quality improvement project is to implement an already evidence-based practice. For example, the purpose is to implement an evidence-based tool to increase the rate of pediatric flu vaccination at a primary care clinic. An example from the Bell article states, the primary objective of this quality improvement project was to implement a systematic approach for care of nulliparous women to reduce cesarean birth rates at three hospitals within one healthcare system. The methods section comes next and should answer the basic question, what did you do? You want someone reading your methods section to very clearly understand what you did and how you measured it. Think about now, looking back. What do you wish you had read prior to starting your own project? What would have helped you be successful in implementing your project? Make sure to include that kind of information here. You want to clearly explain what kind of context this was. A large medical center, a private practice, or an outpatient clinic. What type of unit, organization, and also what type of population was a focus. You want to talk about the team that was involved and how you implemented your project. Was it with in-services, motivational interviewing, handouts, displaying weekly data reports, etc. And then you want to talk about which implementation strategies and tactics you use to adjust your project. For example, did you switch from doing 10-minute in-services at shift change to focusing more on displaying weekly data reports? Was that helpful? Remember, this is not research where sticking to a rigid preset plan is essential. In quality improvement, you can and should change course and adjust your plan if implementation is not working. This is where you can talk about some of those things so that the next person can learn from your project. Here are some examples of the focus in quality improvement versus in research for the sections of methods and data collection. Inclusion and exclusion factors, sample or N sizes, can all be used in both QI and research methods sections. Quality improvement methods outline characteristics of the intervention, implementation strategies and tactics, timeline, team members, and context. Research methods focus more on following a strict research protocol that does not get adjusted. Data collection in QI focuses on evaluation of structures and processes, essentially on what behaviors have changed or were you trying to change. In research, the data collection focuses on answering the specific research question. To learn more about structure, process, and data measurement, you can go to that dedicated QI brief. When preparing to implement your project, you utilized many quality improvement tools. The methods section is where you describe the tools and how they guided your project. For example, you can include your updated theoretical framework diagram, your fishbone diagram, process flow maps you created, or timelines you graphed. If you collected data from a computer charting system or used an established survey, you should discuss that here as well. I highly recommend looking at the Carlin et al. Article referenced on slide 4 for ideas about incorporating a variety of QI tools into your manuscript. This statement focuses on outcomes, but it can be used as an example for how to write statements regarding structure and process as well. It's from the Bell article. To evaluate the primary aim of the project and the secondary aim of subsequent maternal and neonatal outcomes, all medical records of women meeting project criteria were reviewed. Data were collected through retrospective electronic medical record review and recorded on a data collection sheet. The completed data collection sheets were reviewed and data were entered in an Excel database. Aggregate data were collected for the project outcomes. The results section should answer the question, what did you find? Describe the population you ended up actually working with on this project. This may be slightly different than what your original plan was. This should include both the clinicians or other healthcare providers you worked with, as well as the patients or population of focus. For example, how many clinicians did you train on the new protocol? In quality improvement, unlike research, the focus is on data over time. You likely tracked weekly data, and here's where you demonstrate what you collected. The results section is not about interpreting that data. Rather, it's simply about presenting it. This is where you would reference the results of run charts, flow charts, and other forms of data you collected. We want to be able to see over your implementation period, how did it go? Was there an immediate increase in flu vaccination rates after implementing your algorithm, or was it a slow increase over many weeks? You want to discuss your structure and process data as well as your outcomes data. Once again, you are not trying to prove that your project, for example, decreased cancer rates. What you want to show is how successfully you implemented your intervention. For example, how many patients were screened and treated based on the implementation of your new algorithm, or how many clinicians were in-serviced. You also want to address any unintended consequences or unexpected results. Did you in-service more doctors than nurses? Did you collect data that showed something you weren't expecting? In quality improvement, the results section should outline the structure, process, and outcomes data that you collected and how it changed over time. In research, the results focus on the results of the research study and whether a hypothesis was proven or not. In both, you are focusing on a simple display of data and less on the interpretation of that data. Here's an example from the Bell article. Healthcare provider compliance with labor management guidelines increased from 374 to 367. This result focuses on a process measure by discussing how well providers accepted and utilized this new evidence-based tool. Due to the short implementation periods of our DNP projects at the University of Maryland, we often focus more on structure and process data. You certainly can include outcomes data if you were able to collect that information. This example compares a beginning to an end, or a pre versus post data. In order to display how the data changed week to week or over time, the run chart is an excellent tool to use here. In your results section, you should reference your run chart data. I'll briefly highlight a few key elements here, but there is a separate QI brief on how to interpret your run chart data, so please take time to review that before creating and discussing your run charts. As a reminder, there are four rules for interpreting run charts. Rule 1 is used to determine whether you saw a shift. Rule 2 is used to determine whether you saw a trend. Rule 3 is to determine the number of runs you saw. And rule 4 is how you determine whether you saw an astronomical data point in your run chart. You should outline in your results section which of these four rules you may be seeing in your data. Describe the pattern and the time involved when non-random signals occurred. The run chart should be based on a SMART goal. This run chart is based on the goal 100% of infants being cared for in a level 3 NICU will not have a gastric residual checked by a registered nurse prior to each feeding. Be sure your run chart includes all important data. Include in your results section the total number of patients who were included in your data over your entire project and the total number of clinicians who cared for the patients included in your run chart data. In this example, you can see from our previous chart. Rule 1, in this example run chart, there was a shift in the data from pre-implementation median of 43% to a post-implementation median of 89%. Rule 2, these data showed a trend toward meeting the goal and a shift in the median from 43 to 89%. Rule 3, you would include in your results section that there were 5 data points or 1 run above the median. Rule 4, no astronomical data points were identified here. The discussion section should answer the question, what does this mean? What did you learn? You want to summarize and interpret results and then discuss the limitations of your project. In a research paper, the discussion would focus on limitations that were largely technical and statistical, such as issues of blinding, randomization, and sample size. The discussion would focus more on what future research should look like based on what this study found. In quality improvement, the discussion section is about providing meaning for the results you found. You want to answer the question, what did you learn, and how did you learn, and how did what you learned compare to others who attempted to implement a similar project? Which strategies and tactics were the most useful? You want to make connections between your strategies and your results. Did implementing this evidence-based project have the intended outcome? What barriers got in your way, and what things helped to facilitate success? The discussion needs to be very context-specific. Here are some examples of the focus in quality improvement versus in research for what the discussion section. In QI, the discussion focuses on which strategies did and did not work. What were the barriers and facilitators to your implementation? In research, the discussion section focuses more on future research suggestions. And how this research relates to or adds to the literature. In QI, you are not proving efficacy, so you want to stay away from research terminology like proves, evidence, statistically significant, study, and hypothesis, and use words and phrases that draw connections or show differences, like associated with, provide support for, project findings similar, different to existing research. You can see two examples here. This quality improvement project provides initial support regarding the feasibility of implementing a screen for antepartum and postpartum depression in a women's health clinic. Another one would be this quality improvement project to reduce the primary cesarean birth rate across 3 acute care hospitals was associated with a reduction in the cesarean birth rate. A limitation of DNP QI projects is that they are not research. Nothing was randomized or blinded, and your project was very context specific. The fact that your strategy worked in a primary care setting does not mean that your project would be generalizable to a large academic medical center or even to another primary care office. Discussion in a quality improvement project is not about proving anything. It's about explaining associations you saw. You may also want to discuss issues that came up with inequality. Did you mostly reach day shift nurses with your education? After your protocol was implemented, were the patients who received that evidence-based intervention more often white patients than patients of color? Talk about any efforts you made to minimize and adjust for limitations. For more on how to discuss inequality, please refer to the QI brief on ethical considerations and vulnerable populations. Here's a brief list of journals that regularly publish quality improvement articles. You've worked hard on this project, submit it for publication, but know that not all journals regularly publish QI articles, though this is changing. If you're unsure, author queries can be very helpful ahead of article submission. Here are links to some helpful resources, including the rest of the QI brief series, the Health Services and Human Health Sciences and Human Services Library, where you can access the included articles, and a full explanation of the Squire guidelines. If you have any questions or comments, please contact Dr. Bingham. Thank you to our advice steering committee, and here are our references.